Right. Hey Olivia, this is Brett from My Music Lessons. We're going to continue working on Thank You for the Venom by My Chemical Romance. The idea was we're in the key of D major. So D is our 1, then E is our 2, F sharp is our 3, G is our 4, we have an A is our 5, a B is our 6, a C sharp is our 7, and then which resolves back to either an 8 or a 1, right, which is the D. Okay, but what we're going to look at is the chorus. The chorus looks like this. It's a 1 position, 7 position, 6, 4, then back to the 1, 7, 6, 4, and then when we go into either the verse or the bridge, we go back to a 6 position to finish it up. One other thing we talked about that was really important is whenever we're playing through major scales or minor scales, or whatever it is, we're using our thumb to help us not have to look at our fretboard or our left hand while we're playing. We used the key of G as an example of doing like a G5 pointer ring finger, where my thumb is going to be behind the 4th fret, or whatever the fret is in between the two fingers you're using. So I'm on the 3rd and 5th frets, so I'm putting my thumb behind the 4th. Then when I go to position 2, I leave my thumb there and stretch up to position 2. But when I go to position 3, I move my thumb between whatever two fingers I'm using. So 5th fret, 7th fret, my thumb's behind, I'm sorry, 7th fret, 9th fret, my thumb is behind the 8th fret. And then leave it there when you go up to the 4th position, like 3 and 4 right next door. Right, so one more time, it's thumb behind the 1st, stays there for the 2nd. Thumb behind the 3rd, stays there for the 4th. Thumb behind the 5th, stays there for the 6th. Thumb behind the 7th position, stays there for the 8th. And then the idea was, as you're pulling these fingers up, but leaving your thumb there, I'll show you the view from behind. It's the thumb moves out to the side in order to adjust. So it's in a vertical position when it's in between, but when you start moving up, you push it out to the side. The farther away, or the farther up the neck I get, the farther I push the guitar away from me, so that my hand doesn't have to move too much into hyperextending the wrist in this position. Well, not necessarily hyperextending, but just like extending really far. Okay, so that's all I got. Just practice that up and down. Remember that you're in the G scale there, so it's pointer finger as a G, an A, a B, C, D, E, F sharp, G. G5, A5, B5, C5, D5, E5, F sharp 5, G5. You're keeping track of notes with your pointer finger and where your thumb goes. That's all we got. Have fun practicing.